आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट नेटवर्क एंड साइबर सिक्योरिटी प्रेजेंटिंग बाय मंजुनाथ अय्यर असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ईसीई डिपार्टमेंट कैनरा इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज फ्रॉम मैंगलोर।
So in this presentation, I am going to cover about only SSL record protocol and change cipher specification protocol. Basically, these two are protocols having some set of rules. So this is what SSL architecture, and we already know that SSL protocol is implemented above TCP and IP and below HTTP. Okay, so all this together will come under SSL security socket layer protocol. Okay, security socket layer protocol. It's having mainly four things: SSL record protocol, SSL handshake protocol, and SSL change cipher specific protocol, and SSL alert protocol. So now in this presentation, I am going to talk about only these two things, okay? SSL record protocol and SSL change cipher spec, okay, it means specification protocol. Okay, let's move on to the SSL record protocol first, then we'll learn about SSL change cipher specification protocol.
So I'm going to explain about SSL record protocol. Okay, its services is for confidentiality and message integrity. Okay, confidentiality means, so we have to exchange the information between the trusted clients and with the server. Okay, so confidential, so that the data which we are sharing should not be accessed by third party, so without our knowledge. So under confidentiality, here using symmetric encryption with a shared secret key defined by handshake protocol. Okay, so there is a concept called symmetric encryption and asymmetric encryption. In a symmetric encryption, let's say for example, I have a client A and I have a client B. Okay, so data is going to exchange between the client A and client B. Let's say for example, message is sent by client A after encryption. So while encryption is using some secret key, some secret key, let's say for example KS. So he will convert plain text to cipher text by using his secret key, and message is reached at the is received by the client B. So client B is going to receive the cipher text, not plain text. The cipher text is not a readable format. You need to retrieve the plain text, so you have to go for decryption. So while he is going to decrypt the cipher text, you want to use the key. Okay, so in a symmetric encryption, while retrieving a plain text from the cipher text, you want to use the same secret key. Okay, similar secret key is shared between the client A and client B, because client A is already know with whom he is going to communicate. With whom he is going to communicate, and the client B is also know that he is going to communicate with trusted client, that is client A. Okay, so secret key is shared between the client A and client B. So while encryption and decryption, they are using the same key. Okay, that is what okay, symmetric encryption. In similar way, okay, when the okay message is sent by client B with the client A, so we have to use the same okay secret key for encryption, and the client A is need to use the same secret key for decrypt the ciphertext. So in asymmetric, okay, so when message is sent by client A, so okay, client A, he can use his own secret key. Okay, each user is having pair of key. Okay, secret key and public key. Secret key is not shared with the okay, others, and public key may share with others. Okay, so client A is having a secret key. Client B is having a secret key. Okay, which is not going to share with okay others. Suppose for okay encryption, client A is using his secret key, and he will change plain text to ciphertext, and ciphertext will be okay sent to what, client B. So client B will receive the ciphertext. Okay, you want to retrieve the okay plain text. So during that time, okay, for a decryption, a decrypt the plain text, you want to use okay public key of user A, because public key is already shared okay with the client B. Okay, client B. So here for encryption, secret key of client A is used, and okay for a decryption okay is using public key of the client A. So different keys are being used okay for encryption and decryption. So this is what asymmetric. And similarly, if okay for encryption, if he is using a public key of okay client A, so during decryptions, so client B have to use his secret key. Okay, so like that. Okay, how okay asymmetric encryption will work out. Okay, so here confidentiality, symmetric encryption means the same secret key is used for encryption and same key is used for decryption. Okay, and that secret key is already shared by handshake protocol. Okay, message is compressed before encryption if necessary. This is optional actually. This is optional. Okay, this is optional. Okay, so what I mean to say is, so compression is optional if plain text is okay size is too much. Okay, I have large size, so while we are going for encryption, it takes too much of time to convert plain text to ciphertext, so we need to reduce the okay plain text size, so we can go for compression. So while we are going for compression, okay, we have to choose a particular algorithm. So many algorithms are available for compression. Okay, so which algorithms we are going for compression, so that algorithm details should be shared with okay server or other client. It's very important to understand. So message integrity, so under message integrity services, using a MAC with a shared secret key, so it's a secret key MAC, okay, message authentication code okay will be used at the client, and while okay it's get connected with the server or other client, okay, usually server, okay, client will be connected with the server, so that secret key is shared with the server okay if it is trusted. Okay, and okay similarly HMAC, okay, hash MAC, but with a different padding. So we are using MAC along with the hash function. So we'll apply hash function with some okay hash code. Hash code will be generated by hash algorithm. Okay, so extra security we are adding. We are going to padding technique. Okay, padding is nothing but we are just adding some okay extra bits to match the length of the bit. So why we go for integrity? So integrity concept is very simple. If message is okay theft by okay third party, so we should understand the communication, whatever is okay established between the client and server is not in safe. Okay, someone is trying to okay view the data what is being transmitted or communicating between the client and server. Okay, so understanding okay, well, if any mischief or malicious okay things are going to happen during the message transfer. Okay, so this is all about message integrity and confidentiality. Okay, we'll go for next slide. So next, SSL protocol, record protocol operation. Okay, it's very important to understand. So first, okay, I'm going to start with application data. So application data is an information. Okay, yeah, it's a data that we are going to communicate over an insecure network. Okay, we are going to share with the client to server, and server will okay again communicate with okay, server to the other client. Okay, to whom we are going to send. So first, it has to connect with the server. Okay, so very simple. So application data is a plain text which we are going to okay, send to the server or other client. So first, okay, we are going to divide the plain text, entire plain text, into okay n number of blocks, and each block, okay, we are saying that it's a fragment. Each block we are going to share as a fragment, or each fragment we can consider as a data packets. So we know that the data is going to be okay is going to transfer in terms of like data packets. Okay, so now each data packet is having okay like n number of bits. Okay, so now whatever we are going to add for okay other security techniques, like say for example encryptions we are going to add, so we are going to okay perform the encryption for n number of bits, okay, which we are going to treat as a block. So it's a block cipher. Okay, it's a block cipher. It's not a bit cipher, because we are not considering okay single bit and then we are going to perform what encryption, and okay then we are changing okay plain text to cipher text. Okay, so now let me consider each fragment or each block. Okay, and we go for compression, and we go for MAC, and we go for okay encrypt, and we go for okay SSL record header. It has to undergo through all these way. Okay, so then we are okay going to send the fragment. Okay, the same similar okay thing is going to happen for okay all the fragments. So we need to identify the fragment. Okay, for each fragment, okay, in order to identify, we'll give some sequence number. Let's say this is okay fragment 1, fragment 2, and fragment 3. Okay, in order to identify okay for which fragment we are going to perform, we'll identify the fragment with sequence number. This sequence number can be represented by using okay number of bits. Okay, like okay byte, 8 bits we are going to represent with okay 8 bits or 4 bits, whatever. So now let me consider a single fragment. Okay, it's a fragment 1. First, we are going to perform what? Compression. If the size of the fragment is okay very large, we need to reduce the okay, size of the fragment. Okay, so we go for compress. If the size of the fragment is very less, so we no need to go for compress. Okay, so whatever the size of the fragment is there, so directly, so we can consider for next level, that is add MAC. Okay, again I'm telling this is optional. This is what optional. See here, the size of the fragment is okay too much. So after we are going for a compression, okay, the size of the fragment is reduced. So while compression technique, okay, so there are several algorithms are available. So we have to choose which algorithms we are using for compression technique. So because it has to share with a server for okay decompress it. So during decompression, so you want to use the same algorithm. So if he is using different algorithms, we are not able to decompress it. So next, add MAC. Okay, so MAC is what? It's a secret MAC allocation. Okay, we are using a secret key. Message authentication code, and we are going to add that. I mean, we are going to append it here. See, we are going to. This is what compressed plain text. So here, just we are going to add MAC. It's some secret key. It's a KS. Okay. So now can say there are two blocks here. This is a compressed. This is what compressed. Okay. Plain text or a fragment, and here added MAC. So next, encryption. Okay, we are going to perform the encryption on both compressed plain text and the MAC. Okay, here till here it's a plain text. So after we are performing encryption, okay, this is what will change as cipher text. Okay, change as cipher text. So which is non-readable format now. Okay, so here cipher text is adopted for compressed plain text and MAC together. Okay, so now in the next level, just we are going to append SSL record header. Here there is a record header. Can you see here the record header? For a cipher text, just we are going to append one more record header. So where this record header, it carries some information related to what? Encryption, related to what? MAC, and related to what? Compress. So which related to encryptions? Information related to what? Whether it's a symmetric encryption or asymmetric encryption, and which algorithms is adopted for encryption? So like that. For a MAC, we are using secret key, right? Secret code. So that secret code will be attached. So next, compression. Which compression algorithms have been used? And what was the plain text size? After compression, what was the what is the compressed size? So like these many information is carried in record header. So now we got what? Cipher text plus SSL record header. SSL record header. SSL record header we have now. So this appended SSL record header and cipher text is what is being transferred, and it is shared with what? Server, and through the server it will send to the client with whom we want to communicate. So the same thing is going to repeat for fragment 2, and same thing is going to repeat for fragment 3, and so on until it reaches it finishes all the fragments. So we'll go to the next topic then. So in previous slide we came to know that how SSL record protocol works. Initially, what we have application data in the form of plain text. Then we will divide that application data or plain text into number of blocks, manageable blocks. Each block is having some length. Each block we can say it's a packet, data packets. And for each fragment we will go for compression if it is necessary, or else we'll consider directly the plain text or a fragment. Then we are going to add MAC. Next, for plain text and MAC,
we perform the encryption. Okay, we will get a ciphertext. This is what a ciphertext. Okay, for plain text or added MAC. Then we are going to append some SSL record data. Okay, going to add some SSL data. It carries some information. What information it is going to carry? There are four information it is going to carry. First one, content type. Second one, major version. Third one, minor version. Fourth one, compressed length. So here it is a encrypted data for plain text and added MAC, so that we can see here. Okay, see, encrypted for plain text and are compressed. Okay, it's optional. So MAC, message authentication code, it's a secret code having its length is, secret code length is what, either 16 or 20 bytes. So together for plain text and MAC we are going to perform the encryption. So it is encrypted, and also we are going to append what, append SSL record header. A record header, it carries the information. Okay, four information it is going to carry. Let's see one by one. Okay, first one is content type. So what type of the message we are we are going to send. Okay, content type. So that information is given by 8 bits. Okay, like the higher layer protocol used to process the enclosed fragment. Okay, what is the meaning of enclosed fragment? First we have a fragment, then we perform compression if necessary, then we are adding MAC. Okay, then we perform the encryption. Okay, so that is an enclosed fragment. It's the higher protocol that is used to process. So major version, so what is a major version? So that information is carried in 8 bits. Okay, so now SSL v3, okay, we are using, currently we are using SSL v3. For SSL v3, what is a major version? Major version is, it indicates a major version of SSL in use. The value is what? 3. For SSL v3, major version is 3. So minor version, what type of minor versions we are using in SSL v3? That information is again carried in 8 bits. It indicates minor version in use. For SSL v3, the minor version value is 0. Minor version value is 0. Next, compressed length. So after we perform the compression, so what is final the size of the compressed length? So that compressed length, in order to give the information, it uses 16 bits. Okay, I mean, to say the size of the compression length, okay, we are using 16 bits. The length in bytes of the plain text fragment. Okay, this is all all these information is hidden or is carried by SSL record header here. SSL record header. So next, let's see about change cipher spec specification protocol. So now, one of three SSL specific protocol which use the SSL record protocol is a single message. It's a single message causes pending state to become current state. Okay, cipher may have several state. Okay, so sometimes it's a pending state, and once everything is clear, so it's ready to send it to the server. So maybe we have to track the status of cipher every time, like causes a pending state to become current state. What is the current state? Hence, we need to updating. Okay, we need to update. Since updating the CyberSuit that we are using. Okay, CyberSuit in use. So change the Cypress specific protocol. This information is given by 1 byte, and its value is always one. Okay, decimal value is always one. Change the cipher specific protocol. This is what all this is all about. Change the cipher specific protocol. Okay, so we have learnt SSL record protocol. Then SSL change the cipher specific protocols. So thank you so much.